Lovely fireworks girl Yomiya Electro Archon herself, the Raiden Shogun aka Ball, and her excellency Kokomi. Which of these three new characters should you be going for? We're going to be going over their free-to-play viability, a little bit about what their kits are about, and the possibility for these characters to be the most unique in the future. So strap in, let's go. Let's touch on, first of all, fireworks girl Yomiya. This is the character we know the most about because she was actually already in the game already due to her little story quest. So we do know what this character does exactly already. No changes really will probably happen before she is released. And she is gonna be an elemental skill centric character. She's gonna be like child had a kid with Hu Tao, where their damage really comes from their elemental skill activation. So you're gonna have 10 seconds in Yomiya's case to do a bunch of pyro normal attacks. She's a normal attack pyro focused character. Her elemental burst here does do a little bit of support ability here because it's going to do a small amount of damage and then apply a pyro debuff where that enemy will detonate AoE pyro every 2 seconds. You could see this lend its usefulness in some sort of weird compositions based around swirl and swirling overload around, or swirling a melt or vaporized version of your swirls around, and that could be very powerful as well. But that is not what everyone is going to be doing with her, although I do expect a lot of people to be doing that indeed to kind of sort of maximize her use as a sub DPS support burst DPS character, which is really what she is all about. She does have a level 2 charge tech though, and sadly the level 2 charge tech is pretty bad. She's not Ganyu 2.0. She's more like we said, Hu Tao in child. A little bit easier to play than Hu Tao because she doesn't have this life drain aspect, but she's also single target focused just like Hu Tao, and I do believe she's going to be doing just a little bit less damage than Hu Tao would with equal gear and opportunity. Now there is a cool thing about her though in her free to play viability, and this comes from her two very powerful 4-star weapons. You have the Rust as well as the new crafted weapon, the Hamayumi, both focused on normal attack damage, large amounts of increases. R5 Rust is 80%. R5 Hamayumi is gonna be 64%. As long as you have 100% of your elemental burst gauge filled and active. And a lot of players are gonna just be kind of ignoring her elemental burst. And even if you don't, you're gonna be elemental bursting right before you swap off the battlefield. So both those weapons are fantastic options for lovely girl Yomiya. There also, there's going to be a very new powerful set. You could use the Crimson Witch set, but there also is the Shimanawa's Reminiscence set here. 2-piece, 18% attack, and 4-piece, when you use your elemental skill, if you have 15 or more energy, you lose 15 energy, you get 50% normal charging and plunging attack damage for 10 seconds. And like we said, she's all about normal attack, so this is going to be a very good set for you to upgrade to if you so desire. You could also just stick with none other than the Crimson Witch of the Flames. This set is going to be a monster for her as well. So if you're looking for sort of a pyro DPS, your first one, she's gonna be pretty easy to use, but she's gonna be single target focused, and that's really kind of her gimmick, right? Unless you really try to abuse her elemental burst in certain ways, she's gonna be the most straightforward character out of these three. Now before we could talk about the Electro Archon, we need to talk about Electro as an element itself. Electro as an element itself is still kind of lacking when it comes to its ability to have proper play with all the other popular elements. We're talking about good old pyro, hydro, as well as none other than cryo here. So they don't really have the ability to bump up their own damage like the other three popular elements do. They do have a way to play with them, but it's usually with an animal character swirling all the electro around so that they can do electro charge, and you have an EM animal character using the electro element. Now what's going on here right now is we're seeing with the electro traveler that they are kind of coming into a way in fruition of their own, where it's sort of ER base. We have the new Emblem of Severed Fate set that bumps your elemental burst damage up. A lot of the electro characters have very high elemental burst costing skills, and they have this new thing with the traveler, and we know that the traveler is always like the mini me form of the Archon. So you can see this whole energy recharge thing is really coming to fruition with this archetype. What does this mean? It means kind of making them not really as an element electro related reaction focused outside of really superconduct. So this means that while pyro, cryo, and hydro all work super well together with the reaction-based reactions that they have, then you have stuff like geo, physical, and electro. And we say physical because you're using someone like Eula or another cryo character to bump up the physical character's damage, that they're sort of like the brute force elements in Genshin Impact. We're gonna see more of this stuff when it comes to the Electro Archon. And you can see even in her own fight, she's gonna be wearing a pole arm, and she also hints at having the ability to mess around with elemental skills slash elemental Burst. So she's going to be the most unique character out of all of them. And just like the Traveler, you're going to have a Traveler where their skills are kind of flipped around. The Traveler's elemental skill is the energy regen, and their elemental burst is sort of their off the battlefield damage. I suspect that this is going to be flipped around, and you're going to have a very strong version of the Electro Archon. Archons are always very good, and she's gonna be the most unique if you're into that brute force category where you're using Geo and physical characters, especially a girl named Eula, very strong there as well. So look for her to be the most unique character out of all of them, and she also is gonna have a set that works incredibly well with her, which is the Emblem of Severed Fate set, energy recharge for themselves, and then increases elemental burst damage based on up to 75% of your energy recharge. And this is gonna do wonders for the Electro Archon, Ball, whatever you wanna call her, Raiden Shogun. She's gonna be awesome and is gonna be a very nice pickup for a lot of characters, and probably the number one longevity character out of the three that we're going to talk about. And as for free-to-play weapon availability for the Raiden Shogun, energy recharge weapons are kind of pretty easy to pick up on. And rumor has it, I don't know, but rumor has it there's gonna be another weapon for her to pick up for that is completely free. And that could be a thing that really bumps Raiden Shogun up for you as a free-to-play player if you're in that brute force category of Geo and physical in Electro as well. She also will play pretty well in these firework teams, the ones that swirl, Electro Charge, and possibly Overload in the future. The last character here is gonna be Kokomi, a 5-star Hydro Catalyst character. You can see from the war cutscene that she is going to be a healer. Everyone's dying, she shows up, throws bubbles everywhere, and everyone's like, so refreshing. She's like Anduin, where he just mass reses everybody in the cutscene for World of Warcraft. She's definitely going to be a healer of some sort. I do believe that she is going to probably scale off of HP because she's, you know, she's a water character, right? We need Barbara 2.0 at this point. And rumor has it, I don't really know all that much, okay? But she's going to scale off of HP percent, and she's going to also scale her damage off of HP percent. It's really hard to stay away from big old leakers, but yeah, that's pretty much what she's going to do in essence. She's an on-the-field healer that can do some damage as well. And I personally don't really like these characters all that much outside of maybe in multiplayer. So characters like Jean, Chi-Chi, Barbara, you're trying to really maximize the damage potential of your team. It's nice that she's gonna be able to do some sort of damage while out on the battlefield. However, for it to truly matter, she's gotta be matching or right under your main DPS character. And that is so hard to do, right? Is she gonna do as much damage as Razor and Diluc and Hu Tao and Yomiya and all this other stuff? Probably not. So that's something you really need to think about there. Of course, things could always change. She could wind up doing the most amount of damage of anyone, right? She could have this crazy scaling on whatever, and she comes out and just like hits everything for like 90 million damage. Is that gonna happen? Probably not. I don't really think MiHoYo is ready to release a healer that has more damage than every other character in the game. So even if all those rumors are true, I don't know about that, guys. I think that she is probably the second most unique design-wise character, but probably the worst out of the three to pull on. I think Ball is going to be the most unique character and probably the one you guys need to pull on the most. Then you have Yomiya, who's probably dead last because she is just a damage-dealing character at the end of the day there. But she does have a little bit of, you know, sort of weirdness with her elemental burst. We can do cool things with the damage off the field of Pyro, which is not really something that we've had access to before outside of like the little teddy bear Guoba from Xingling or Pyronado. So we've had one other character that can do that, and we can see just how strong that effect is. However, Yomiya's damage on that little proc over time isn't that big of a deal there. So that's not as strong as Pyronado is in any way, shape, or form. And then you have the good old Kokomi, who's this like healer type character. However, you have so many good healers, right? Like Bennett. Like Bennett heals, he's not on the field, he gives a giant attack buff. You see characters like that just take over the game, or characters like a big shield with Diona who can heal off the field. You know, someone like Zhong Li who's reducing resistances and has giant HP barriers and a petrify boulder. Is she gonna be that unique? Is she gonna be that awesome? I don't think she's gonna hold up to someone like Bennett. I know you can't use two Bennets, but like Bennett is so good. In order for my healer to want it to be better than Bennett, that's what I'm really saying about that character. I think you could pull for her and you probably have fun with her and stuff, but really at the end of the day, if you're trying to go for most efficient resources used on Primos, I don't think like a new healer that has to heal on the field is what you need to be aiming for. Just stick to Bennett, man. Bennett's so good. Now, personally, I'm going to be pulling for the Electro Archon. I think MaHoYo has it in them. They released Zhongli, made him busted biscuits broken afterwards. Venti was always busted biscuits broken. Banana sandwich, cream pie, cheese on top. Well, not cheese, but like whipped cream on top with a cherry. I think that the Archons are always going to just be super unique in that way. They're all apparently going to be support sub DPS characters in some which way or form. And that means that they're going to have the longest longevity of all characters in Genshin Impact. So if you want the most use of your primos, that's probably who I'd go for out of those three as the Electro Archon. And that's what I'm doing as well, guys. If you want to see more Genshin Impact stuff, hit that sub button, hit the like for the algorithm, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care, guys.